Bonds issued by acquirer of Mattress Firm and Sherwood Bedding collapse after ACT buys them as part of QE. Steinhoff's accounting irregularities crush its stock. If you're holding shares or bonds of a company, such as Steinhoff International Holdings, which acquired Mattress Firm Holding in 2016, Sherwood Bedding in 2017, and a bunch of other companies well, you don't want to get this kind of corporate announcement, even if you're the ACT that bought the bonds that Steinhoff's European subsidiary had issued just this July. The supervisory board of Steinhoff wishes to advise shareholders that new information has come to light today which relates to accounting irregularities requiring further investigation. The supervisory board, in consultation with the statutory auditors of the company, has approached PwC to perform an independent investigation. Marcus Joost, CEO of Steinhoff, has today tendered his resignation with immediate effect, and the board has accepted the resignation. After the press release of accounting irregularities appeared today, Steinhoff's shares, which are traded in Frankfurt, plunged 64% in one fell swoop and closed at €1.07. Investors have been smelling a rat for months. Even yesterday's closing price of €2.95 was already down 41% from the €5 range in June. And you don't want to hold the bonds when this debacle happens. But being smart, you're not holding the bonds, you sold them to the ACT, which has acquired them under its corporate bond purchase program that is part of its QE. It would be funny if it weren't so ugly. Steinhoff Europe AG issued the €800 million of bonds in July 2017. The bonds, with a 1.875% coupon, mature in January 2025. Moody's rates them Ba3, so one notch above junk. Hence they were eligible for ACT purchases. To keep its bond operations opaque for the public, the ACT doesn't disclose by name what it buys, how much it buys, or when it buys those bonds. But it discloses a list of its current bond holdings. You can download the list here and search it for Steinhoff. And voila! Those bonds were trading at over 100 cents on the euro shortly after they were issued in July, probably under the pressure from the ACT's purchases. Today, they plunged 33% to 56.18 cents on the euro and are down 45% from mid-September. Steinhoff became a powerful force on the acquisition circuit in 2016, acquiring 9 large retailers and related companies, in addition to the retailers it already owned. In the US, it acquired Mattress Firm Holding in September 2016 for $2.4 billion and a majority stake in mattress manufacturer Sherwood Bedding in July 2017. It got to the point where Wall Street was asking, while licking its chops, who would Steinhoff buy next? But in addition to the accounting irregularities, perhaps designed to cover up some unpleasant issues, Steinhoff has some operating problems. According to Bloomberg, retail sales have been weak, and this Christmas after a much better than expected festive season in 2016 is looking grim. Add in higher input costs thanks to the slump in the pound, and that some rental payments are due at the end of December, and that could make for a toxic combination. Moody's, in rating the misbegotten bonds, wrote on July 13th with unintended irony, "A decentralized management model mitigates inherent risks associated with an ever-evolving organizational structure spanning a number of countries and business sectors with integrating multiple acquisitions. Management teams remaining post-acquisition allows for a seamless transition and are aligned with group operating performance success through remuneration comprising a considerable long-term equity award component." Now the ACT holds some of these bonds. It shows what risks the ACT is taking by buying corporate bonds. Though the ACT doesn't buy junk-rated bonds, it buys bonds that are rated just above junk, such as the Steinhoff bonds, and it buys not-rated bonds of undetermined quality. Due to downgrades, it ends up with junk-rated bonds. The chart, based on data from UBS and Bloomberg, shows that the ACT recently held 26 issues of junk bonds rated BB+ or below on Standard & Poor's scale, 233 issues of not-rated bonds, NR, and 84 issues rated just above junk, BBB, but these are the boom times for Euro corporate bonds, and particularly junk bonds, boom times because the ACT has been buying these instruments, purposefully inflating their prices and pushing down yields. This scheme allowed a company like Steinhoff to borrow at a cost below 2%. However, the average Euro junk bond yield, currently at 2.5% according to the BofA Merrill Lynch Euro High Yield Index, is up sharply from peak bond market benightedness in early November, when the average junk bond yield fell briefly below 2.1%. Investors are starting to wonder what will come next, as the ECB will further taper its bond purchase program. And the Steinhoff bonds underline how the ECB has become a bad bank of sorts, buying bonds from weak companies and watching how the bonds crash on its books. The tax cuts and elevated asset prices are on the Fed's table. National Bank of Canada's Economics and Strategy came out with a note this morning, warning that economists and the markets might be underestimating the hawkishness of the Fed next year, even considering the low rate of U.S. inflation. Monetary policy in the world's largest economy is arguably too loose. It's the first time since the 1970s that real interest rates are in negative territory despite a positive output gap. Some Fed members are now even expressing concerns about financial imbalances fearing a sharp reversal in asset prices, according to the latest minutes. Recently approved tax cuts by Congress also warrant normalizing monetary policy. As such, we believe the Federal Reserve will raise interest rates more than what markets are currently expecting in 2018. Markets just don't believe the Fed can significantly tighten monetary policy, the team, led by Stéphane Marion, chief economist and strategist, wrote in the note. The Fed funds rate is expected to be below 2% by the end of 2020, in sharp contrast to the Fed's own view that rates will be closer to 3% by then. This market view has no doubt been shaped by years of disappointing readings on both wage growth and the overall inflation rate, which have seemingly eroded trust in the Fed's ability to hit its 2% inflation target. Both Janet Yellen and Jerome Powell, who will succeed her in February, have been on the same page, emphasizing over and over again that the Fed should continue the gradual process of normalizing monetary policy. Normalizing monetary policy is a rubbery concept. A number of Fed governors have suggested that the neutral rate would be around 2.5%. Deutsche Bank above said it would be closer to 2.75%. Neutral means that the accommodation of the past 9 years has been removed, as the Fed likes to phrase it. Any actual tightening of monetary policy would start at that point. But for now, the entire conversation is about removing accommodation. And the tax cuts are adding fuel to the brush fires that the Fed is trying to step out. The Fed's projection of 3 more hikes next year didn't take into account any potential tax cuts. A little over a year ago, the Fed stopped flip-flopping and has since done everything it said it would do, including the QE unwind that commenced in October. But markets have simply brushed off the Fed. This might set the scene for these willfully blind markets to get tripped up by a hawkish surprise next year. Even as lawmakers cobbled together a tax cut bill that would cut revenues by about $1.5 trillion over 10 years, the gross national debt has spiked $723 billion over the past 12 weeks, to 105% of GDP. Bonds issued by acquirer of mattress firm and Sherwood Bedding collapse after ACT buys them as part of QE. Steinhoff's accounting irregularities crush its stock. If you're holding shares or bonds of a company, such as Steinhoff International Holdings, which acquired Mattress Firm Holding in 2016, Sherwood Bedding in 2017, and a bunch of other companies, well, you don't want to get this kind of corporate announcement, even if you're the ECB that bought the bonds that Steinhoff's European subsidiary had issued just this July. The supervisory board of Steinhoff wishes to advise shareholders that new information has come to light today which relates to accounting irregularities requiring further investigation. The supervisory board, in consultation with the statutory auditors of the company, has approached PwC to perform an independent RIM. Add in higher input costs thanks to the slump in the pound, and that some rental payments are due at the end of December, and that could make for a toxic combination. Moody's, in rating the misbegotten bonds, wrote on July 13 with unintended irony, "A decentralized management model mitigates inherent risks associated with an ever-evolving organizational structure spanning a number of countries and business sectors with integrating multiple acquisitions. Management teams remaining post-acquisition allows for a seamless transition and are aligned with group operating performance success through remuneration comprising a considerable long-term equity award component." Now the ECB holds some of these bonds. It shows what risks the ECB is taking by buying corporate bonds. Though the ECB doesn't buy junk-rated bonds, it buys bonds that need investigation. Markus Joost, CEO of Steinhoff, has today tendered his resignation with immediate effect, and the board has accepted the resignation. After the press release of accounting irregularities appeared today, Steinhoff's shares, which are traded in Frankfurt, plunged 64% in one fell swoop and closed at €1.07. Investors have been smelling a rat for months. Even yesterday's closing price of €2.95 was already down 41% from the €5 range in June. And you don't want to hold the bonds when this debacle happens. But being smart, you're not holding the bonds, you sold them to the ECB, which has acquired them under its corporate bond purchase program that is part of its QE. It would be funny if it weren't so ugly. Steinhoff Europe AG issued the €800 million of bonds in July 2017. The bonds, with a 1.875% coupon, mature in January 2025. Moody's rates them BA3, so one notch above junk. Hence they were eligible for ECB purchases. To keep its bond operations opaque for the public, the ECB doesn't disclose by name what it buys, how much it buys, or when it buys those bonds. But it discloses a list of its current bond holdings. You can download the list here and search it for Steinhoff. And voila! Those bonds were trading at over 100 cents on the euro shortly after they were issued in July, probably under the pressure from the ECB's purchases. Today, they plunged 33% to 56.18 cents on the euro and are down 45% from mid-September. Steinhoff became a powerful force on the acquisition circuit in 2016, acquiring 9 large retailers and related companies, in addition to the retailers it already owned. In the US, it acquired Mattress Firm Holding in September 2016 for $2.4 billion and a majority stake in mattress manufacturer Sherwood Bedding in July 2017. It got to the point where Wall Street was asking, while licking its chops, who would Steinhoff buy next? But in addition to the accounting irregularities, perhaps designed to cover up some unpleasant issues, Steinhoff has some operating problems. According to Bloomberg, retail sales have been weak, and this Christmas after a much better than expected festive season in 2016 is looking good.